Joined now by Tom, Justin Russell from Editors. Where's that film, that video?
About an hour and a half outside of LA.
LA?
Yeah.
Good fun?
It was an intense day. Windy. I've had a haircut.
A lot of takes.
Yeah.
It's a cool video. I was watching it last night and it is very cool.
Cool. Thank you.
The album's called the same as the single.
It is.
Black God. But this is a best of.
It is.
Tell us why you decided to do a best of right now.
It's been about 15 years, 6 records, 3 with Justin in the band, and 3 from before. Felt like the right time, bit of symmetry there. Felt like a good time to be.
So new tracks too, aren't there? So three new tracks.
Yeah.
Mm. So how did you select the songs? Because that's a lot of material to get from 6 albums.
Yeah, just you try and represent every record and pick some songs, obviously, that people will know. But our careers, like, over the years, it's kind of, we have, Editor's Best Of would be very different in Belgium or Italy or England. You know, they'd all be very different. So to pick, we just had to kind of talk about it, really, didn't we?
Did you do it purely on kind of personal level? Sort of go, right, OK, love this, that's a definite. And then almost like there must be some where you go in, is it that or that?
There's a bit of that.
Yeah.
There's a bit of that. Obviously, there's not like, they're not all just the singles that have come out.
Yeah.
They're like ones that mean something to us as a band.
And our fans as well, you know. We haven't got 15 years of top 10 singles.
And you're touring it. When are you going to start?
February, yeah.
February. Where are you going in the world? Is it just UK or are you...
UK and Europe, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, big European tour. Doing lots of big shows. Going to Russia. Should be fun.
You know, when you embark on a tour that's quite an extensive tour, is there almost an element sometimes, if not dread, you think, wow, that's next year sorted. I almost know what's going to happen for the next 365 days.
It's pretty daunting. I mean, it is for me, because I have a weird way about going around touring, but when you can see on a piece of paper where you're going to be for essentially the next, like, 10 months of your life, then you're like...
What's your weird way?
I'm not very good on tour buses, so I travel by myself. So I
say... Oh, here we go.
In a
Tom
hire
did
car,
say that driving. To me before.
So I spend a lot of time driving around Europe on my own in a hire car.
Why?
I don't know. It's been the last few years.
You don't sleep, mate, do you?
I don't sleep very much on buses, so now I just get a car. I don't know, you know, it's really good. I get to see most
all the
of the places.
And
essentially, you know, driving over the Alps a few times a year, it's good fun.
I quite like the idea of that.
It's yeah.
You need to be organised.
You have to be very organised.
Would you allow someone else to come in the car with you, or is it you like your solidarity?
I mean, I've taken you to the airport a couple of times.
Yeah. fly either?
Yeah, yeah.
You're not the Dennis Bergkamp music.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
That's an interesting way of doing
it. It's a good way of doing it.
Have you ever got to the gigs and you're like, oh, he's not showing up?
Always there.
You were very prompt, you're good.
He's
always asleep in the dressing room as well.
Yeah, yeah.
You're just saying pockets of Europe have different, like, well, you said Belgium really likes you and stuff like that. Different. How does it work out that certain areas like you and more than others?
I don't know, really. It's weird how some set of songs resonate differently. Like our fourth record, we ended up on Italian X Factor. So, you know, and that record, you know, wasn't so well recognised here, but, like, yeah, it's just the way it goes.
But has it changed over the 15 years that have been together? Because, I mean, you know, of course, there was the internet support.
Not as a contestant, like, by the way. Yeah. We were just...
Because it has changed, you know, the music industry has changed so much in those 15 years. So almost that, the geographical boundaries, it must sort of, must alter as well.
Sorry, we're talking about Brexit now.
So when you release something now, it's immediate, isn't it? Whereas when you start almost like to establish yourselves in Belgium, Italy, whatever it might be, then you've got to get on the road and kind of do it. Whereas now, I guess, you almost don't really.
Yeah. I think for us, it put us in good stead because playing live has been such a big part of our continued kind of success, really, because we've always been quite, you know, we're right at it. So, we've like the year before last, we did 103 shows or something in the year, so it's always been like that, you know.
The music industry's changed dramatically, hasn't it, in the last 15 years?
But
the one thing which hasn't changed is live.
Yeah.
That's still, people turn up, they want to see the band.
Yeah.
That's the deal. But the recording side of it has changed dramatically, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, when we came out, we had our first review on Teletext.
Yeah, we did, yeah.
Teletext?
Yeah.
I mean, it was about 15 years ago. And I mean, MySpace awesome. Was a thing just.
Just about, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, all CDs.
CDs, yeah.
There you go.
Those.
Yeah.
One of those. But is it nice, though, because you're still releasing vinyl? Is that important to you, though?
You sell more of them now than you do CDs, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a real kind of resurgence in that market, which is really cool.
Nice things as well.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, beautiful things. Yeah.
Nice to touch. Right, thanks, guys. Black Gold, as well as tickets for your upcoming tour, are out now, and you'll be performing live for us at the end of the show.
Yeah. After break, we're in the kitchen with McFly.